首先就是抱歉一下，正式抱歉一下。本来我们在之前这个申请之前，我们会有个申请是选择两年，可以介绍在培训用的还是经验。但是最近大陆的签证问题，所以我们就到大陆的同事安排过来。我曾经试着帮他办商务签证，签证时间花了比较久，一直到前一天才下来。但是他下来的时候，他说。直接从家乡转业，拿了商务签证以后，现在在大陆那边在办理手续，他就直接从深圳那边过来，所以他觉得香港的那种形势他有点害怕，他就最后一个时间就跟我讲说，就是来不了，所以前面就报备一下时间，他这个申请，然后我们就直接到下一个申请，那这个申请我讲大概非常重要的申请，很多人有兴趣，还是有兴趣。买水口的训练通常很多人觉得买水训练不好啊，或是买水的肯定不够啊，你像有很多地方你是不够好的，那你考的三十考的最有时候不一样买水的训练考的三分半。那我们很高兴请到杨大肯，是我们在两开地区日本跟两开地区的职业工程师，他对买水非常丰富的经验，他甚至自己买水过两百台水壶啊，他利用这个时间呢，我想是如何了解一下对于新能源条约上面的一些问题。那我们来一起欢迎马太上。
你好，我是长期居家我台邻居的。 number with the face card, the 2 pairs of mask is higher than 5%. This box is disability or disability, right? Pension. In the paper, this one, my scale is higher than 2 pairs of my scale is higher than 5%. As this one, the new version improves best performance. In action, the new version also has the benefit of improved optimizers. This work compares the distribution time with 5.6 and 5.7. It shows how much execution time was shortened with 5.7. Assuming 5.6 execution time has 100%. There are 5 SQLs executed in JDBC. JDBC is a benchmarking program testing the question support workload. Therefore, this one is a complex SQL, not simple SQL. In short, this graph shows that the new version can execute more complex queries faster. Therefore, there is a possibility your system can be speed up just one version. Besides this, the new version has features that help improve performance and help with tuning. For example, Visual Explains introduced with Matlab 5.6, MES, MES means Large Scale Thread, introducing 5.6 and improving 5.7 and Matlab 8. Optimizations introducing Matlab 5.7 and so on. There are so many good features that I can't explain in today's coding session, but today I will explain Visual Explain and MES. Explain is used to check SQL execution plan. Execution plan shows how SQL is executed internally. For example, when executing a join in SQL, we don't specify the join order in SQL. However, the optimizer decides the join order by estimating cost. We can confirm such a thing to check the execution order. For 5.6, there is text format explained only. However, since 5.6, there is JSON format explained, and we can see visual explain using MySQL 1. The source of visual explain is JSON format explained. Visual explain is easy to understand. For example, you can check the join order at a glance, like flowchart. In action, you can check access type at a glance. I mean, in Visual Explain, access type is color code. This table describes color coding for Visual Explain. The red row is value type, and the middle row is color. Upper side is good access type, but bottom side is not good access type. So if we see blue and green, it is good. But if we see the red, it is not good. So if we say I recommend that you check whether the index is used properly. You can use Visual Explain by MySQL Workbench. MySQL Workbench is official J0 for MySQL Developer. MySQL Workbench is official J0 for MySQL Developer by MySQL J0. MySQL Workbench has many useful features for SQL development, server management, data modeling, and data migration. If you haven't used the MySQL Workbench yet, please use it at this option. Information such as download link and document can be found here. You can see it today. In action, MySQL Workbench has very useful feature for SQL tuning. I recommend checking query statistics tab also when you tune SQL. Query statistics tab show basic information that should be checked during SQL tuning. About form performance. This is MySQL Workbench. And I already created the connection information. But you can create new connection. And double click MySQL Workbench connect with database. And here is the SQL index. I can SQL. The keyword is highlighted. And push this button if it triggers the SQL index puzzle. And Visual Explain is here. Show the information below. Now, this row should be O. Be O means binary digit. But when I click form it down, it can display. Hokkaido Prefecture. And there is another option, special view. So, isn't special view? Do you know Japanese shape? This one is Japan. We can check the geometry basis. Go, master one. Go.
If we set this parameter to 10, there is 10
There are 10 transactions. Simple is
executed.
Second tuning point is
using write set method for the feature can the feature available in 5.7.22 or later and mass data. This method applies a conflict replication mechanism of group decision. When you use this method, you can execute transaction parallel on the thread, even if the transaction is executed on a single thread on master thread. When we use write set parallelization, we must set two parameters. Transaction write set extraction and inward transaction dependency property. In MySQL 8, we don't need set transaction write set extraction because the default value is good for write set. The default value is XXHA SH64. Regarding window transaction dependency quantum, we can choose write set or write set session. But if thread preserved point order is enabled, basically it is better to select write set. Tuning point using write set method. Window transaction dependency history size. Window transaction dependency history size sets the number of row hashes. This row hash is used to determine that the same row has not been updated. If the upper limit is reached, all row hashes are hashed. So tuning is recommended in environments where there are many rows up to update. This graph shows the performance of the update process on the threads during system benchmark execution. Is commit order and gray bar is write set. Commit order doesn't use write set method and commit order is default. In other words, the efficient of the write set method can be confirmed by comparing commit order and write set. The horizontal axis is the number of clients on the master side. The vertical axis update per second. The point is, even if the parallelism on the master side is low, processing can be performed at a high parallelism on the thread side. Recommended use for the
to your next point. Next point, tuning parameters. Tuning parameters may improve performance. There are so many parameters that I can install. But today, I will explain five typical parameters. The first one is in-living workable size. This figure is an in-living architecture diagram. This figure is published in MySQL document. This side is an in-memory structure, and the right side is a disk structure. In-living workable size are just this area. This area is used to cache data and index. Therefore, increasing this area improves performance because the cache can be built more efficiently and disk bio can be removed. It is not necessary to make it less than the total capacity of data and index, but it is recommended to set it as large as possible. Next parameter is InnoDB row part size. This parameter sets the size of the row part. Row part is here. By default, middle of file created two files and use them cyclically. IB row part there is used first. I will find their usage. The row file records the history of the upgrade process and the history of the upgrade process that has not been proceeded as a checkpoint cannot be overwritten. Therefore, there are many upgrade processes. Next parameter is temptable size and max field page size. This parameter is the upper limit for temporary tables that can be created in memory. When using a temporary table and the sizes, the temporary table is stored in memory. But if the size is large, a temporary table is created in the disk. Since using this view, the integrated performance. So, therefore, it is desirable to process memory as much as possible. If MySQL Server is creating a temporary table on this, you should change this parameter to reserve. Created 10 disk tables status variable to confirm the number of times a temporary table is created on disk. There are created 10 tables status variables and there are 10 created 10 disk tables status variables. One is sort buffer size. This parameter sets the size of the sort area in memory. If there is not enough space on the memory, the sort result is added to the file and sort. It needs this one. Therefore, it is better to be able to execute sort processing in memory. Please note that since 5.6, the default value was changed from 2 megabytes to 200 56 kilo. And you can check salt merge passage status variable to confirm the number of times by salt water. There are many other parameters that can be changed. As for beginners of parameter, please start with the parameter in this tool. Let's move on to the next point. Next point is use slopeway rod and performance. Future for identifying slope SQL and future for obtaining and checking various performance information. Today, I will include slope error and SysSchema. SysSchema is a future based on performance. Slopeway log is not outputted by default. If you want to output slopeway log, you must enable slopeway log system file. In this log file, all SQL whose execution time is longer than specified by slopeway time output. Log query time is specified in seconds, but you can specify up to microseconds. In addition, you can output all queries that doesn't use an index to enable log queries not using index system value. We can improve performance by finding slow SQL in the slow payload and tuning slow SQL. There are other system variables related to slow payload. For example, if main examined low payload is enabled, with low payload is enabled, SQL is that access a small number of load can be ignored. When using slow query log, MySQL dump slow is very useful. MySQL dump slow is aggregation tool for slow query log. Slow query log continues to be output. Therefore, if there are a lot of output, it is more efficient to check for aggregation. For example, by executing the command in this way, MySQL dump slow accumulates AP and slow payload time, you can solve by average execution time. Based on performance schema. Performance schema is a feature for monitoring the MySQL server application. In fact, this schema is a set of procedures and functions for convenient use of the performance schema. It is very convenient to check performance information. This schema is created by default from MySQL and the server. There are many views and procedures in this schema. I will introduce some examples. This is a schema object overview. We can check the object type and number of objects in the schema, in each schema. Next one is unity buffer specify table. We can check what object exists in unity buffer code and comma styles. Next one is user summary by file item. We can check the amount of file available to each file per user. Next point is statement analysis. We can check SQL that takes a long time to execute. It is very useful for extraction. The last example is innovative workflow. This view is very useful for checking log weights. We can check the information about waiting transaction and blocking transaction as well. Next is conclusion. Let me wrap up today's topic. Do you manage your performance? I think we will use three main topics today. First one is use new version of scale, use innovative. The new version includes basic performance. The new version also has the benefit of improving the optimizers. And there are many good features in new version, such as visual extension. Second point is tune parameters. You can improve MySQL performance by tuning MySQL parameters. There are many parameters that I introduce by parameters. The last topic is useful payload performance demand to understand the scale between my model and the performance. I hope that today's topic will be helpful for you. Thank you very much. Thank you.